Now, I've classily named my save file Allah.
I'm gonna be you, John.
Okay, that's good. That's good. I would actually recommend the stick for this.
How do I go to the stick?
Oh, you're using the stick. Yeah, there you go. You choose this profile, yes.
Okay, we're doing this.
You'll enjoy this. This is very much, if you've played DuckTales, you pretty much know how to play this.
It's been a while, but...
Don't skip. Trust me, it's good. This is a pretty good intro, yeah.
I'm not going to listen to John. I'm going to skip. I'm going to skip right to the fucking game, son! Hells yeah! We're going to do the thingy. We're going to jump around. How do I do the bouncy bounce? I got to be able to bounce. Bow! I'm going to shovel this shit up. And be like, yeah, son. Hit this. I'm going to hit you, man. I'm going to get some shit up on that. What the fuck, son? What you think you're doing? What you think you're doing?
Shrimp chips.
Shrimp chips? I can't grab right now. Anna.
I want shrimp chips. I want snap peas.
The snap pea crisps? Oh, by the way, those are just the son. Japanese
take
ones
that.
From Calvi, but
take
look
it.
At how they redesigned the front.
Yeah, I know. I've
take
seen
it,
these
take
before.
Shovel.
There
take
you go,
that,
Tony.
Son. Oh, thank you so much, sir. I appreciate it. Oh, what's up here, son? Oh, shit. This is definitely more active than a tank dating simulator, to say the least. Read off some of those sweet comments, darling.
Oh, good. Here comes a knight with a shovel to dig my grave.
Oh, my God. What do I do with the jump? Jump attack.
Jump and down.
Ah,
there it is.
Son.
And
what you doing?
You can actually juggle the little bug.
Ah.
Juggle bug.
Chug-a-bug. It's a chug-a-bug. Wait a minute. I want up on this. What? That hurts me?
You got to use it as a jump.
Oh, son.
Now, just if you wait for it, it'll hover at the right position.
Oh, shit. Okay. I'm going to wait for it to hover. Okay.
They're such a cute couple. You can't tell if they're playing Shovel Knight or listening to Adult Contemporary.
Why can't I be both?
All right. It's habiting.
Habiting?
It's habiting.
I don't know if I want to eat one of those plums, Dan.
I want to eat one of those plums. I want to see what those plums has to offer my face.
Tony's drunk.
I'm not drunk, girl.
Definitely.
If I was drunk, I'd be violent. I mean...
Oh, no. They're eating glitches. You should turn your adventure on Hard for Games into an actual game. You know what I mean?
I don't know what you mean.
They're eating glitches.
That chroma key is good. Oh, what the fuck is this? No, I'm gonna fucking beat you, son.
It's a dragon.
Want to go on this?
Is the wine, like, keying out like crazy?
Probably.
I imagine it is.
Die, son. Die. No, son.
Oh, my gosh.
You can tell Tony's drunk because he's
calling
him.
Let me show you this.
There you go. You show me.
All right.
You show me how to do
it. Watch out. That's not a chip. It's a glitch.
Oh.
I really dig this game. Good. I'm glad that I accidentally ruined everything. It definitely has much more going on than the last game did.
I can't wait to play this on the Coleco Chameleon.
I wouldn't say it has more going on.
It does. There's running and jumping.
I would say that there's less sensual tank subtext.
Alright, so watch this, Tony. All you have to do is... Oh.
Richie says, I don't know, Tony, that Shovel Knight does look pretty violent.
Oh, yeah.
Shut up, Richie. I'm still mad at you.
Why are you mad at him?
Because he said I fucked
him.
Damn it. Eat shit. Skeleton.
What do you need to have going on other than breasts? Nothing. Just boobs.
Only boobs. It's the only thing I care about.
Well, the...
Shovel Knight is pretty hot in a mysterious kind of way. You can shovel me.
Oh, yeah, girl.
Zelda's Final Fantasy is a little... She's a little sexual.
She's a little sexual. She has this one video.
But I like her.
So, I was watching her channel once. I watched her channel a couple times. It's good stuff. And she has some video. It's been a while since I've seen it, so I may get some of the details a little bit wrong. But it was something like, help me name my pussy.
Oh, shit. What did you name it?
And so she's like, I need you guys to like help me name my pussy. And I'm like, all right, you know, whatever. I'll help you name
your
pussy.
Is she from England?
No.
Oh, okay.
And then like, it kind of gets into the video. And she's talking about a cat.
Aww.
And I was like, I get it.
Just a little kitty cat. Speaking of kitty cats, our dog thinks he's a cat. And when we take him on walks around the neighborhood, sometimes he tracks cats, and the cats start following us. But then when we turn around to look at them, they're like, oh, I'm not following you. I just happen to be going in the same direction as you. Whatever, I'm going to hide under this car.
Keep him coming.
Are you already playing this in the chameleon since it runs on a capture card circuit board? I named her Navi.
That's a good name for a pussy.
Richie says, you know what the thing about old school games is? There are a ton of big head cheat codes, but no big boob codes.
You're right.
I don't know if that's necessarily a good thing, but it is a thing.
Give me some of those snappies.
Oh.
Thank you for the snaps.
No problem. No problem.
You know, I was really happy to see that Colby had started selling the green pea crisps, because I had thought, you know, this might actually sell well in the U.S. The problem
is, I love these.
They're all like, we have ranch dressing, or black pepper, or like just tomato basil, and I was like, but I really liked like the yuzu and black pepper and like the crazy Japanese flavors. I'm like, just come up with a weird name that Americans might like. Like, just don't change the flavor, because the flavors were amazing. Just make up some shit that you think Americans will like.
Yeah.
Like Hot Wheels.
Yes. Hot Wheels.
Your dog is fucking adorable. Thank you, Amanda. I agree. Even though he is a shit.
Amanda once said, it's like, should I feel bad that Louis is my favorite member of the cast? I was like, no, he's my favorite member of the cast.
Oh, mine too. Yeah, mine too.
However, he is the most destructive. Even though TJ has several times tried to destroy the Wonder Swan.
Yes.
By resting drinks on it.
Stop Drop and Retro says, I'd name a pussy the Velvet Man Trap.
Oh, I like that. That's a good name.
I was hoping for the Velvet Man Child.
Charlie says, shots fired at Calico Chameleon.
Calico.
Calico.
Oh. Amanda says,
it's not the Calico Chameleon.
What a wonderful phrase.
Have you ever seen that movie, Teeth? It's freaking hilarious.
I think that's the first time I've heard it referred to that way.
It's good.
Oh. Are you dropping shrimp chips?
I didn't.
Who needs big boob codes when you already have my Shiranui? Sorry, my pronunciation. I don't know what I'm talking about.
It's a character from King of Fighters. It's very large.
Oh my, yeah. Oh my god. There's like.
Like utter, big ants level?
It. Oh my.
There's the utter hanging out there, yeah.
Like big ants level.
Like, but they're actually attractive, yeah.
Yeah, they're.
They're just like utter is hanging down. Oh my god.
Or DOA volleyball.
Yeah, DOA volleyball. No, but Mai is more than DOA volleyball. She's beyond that.
You know, a friend of mine has actually argued, like, that despite the like, obvious attempts to just try and make that game, like, as, let's see, the Dead or Alive beach volleyball, they're like, yeah, it's sexy, just buy it.
Mm.
I have had many people I know still argue, like, I know it does that, but it is actually a surprisingly fun game. If you just completely blind yourself to that, it's actually a surprisingly fun volleyball game.
Well, it would have to be, because otherwise, I mean, like, boobs are everywhere. Like, why would you spend $60 for a
boobalicious? A game. I'm sorry. That's what you meant. Yeah, yes. That thing.
So, it would have to be at least a decent game, I would imagine.
I have crap all over
me. I fucking love teeth. John, you need to bring shrimp chips next time, okay?
We have shrimp chips right now.
She means when you come to visit her.
Yeah, we have shrimp chips right now.
Wow.
John's really avoiding the subject. Chips.
Wow.
Amanda, I warn you, if you don't
patient
like
woman.
Shrimp, you won't like shrimp chips, and they do smell awful.
I'm going to try one. I've never tried one before.
So,
none tell, of us, shrimp person.
Tell us about your favorite, we're on the topic of boobs, you know, and shrimp. Tell us about your favorite boobs and or favorite shrimp in gaming.
Mmm. By the way, Tony, recent Goodwill find, I found a VHS copy of the first couple episodes of Earthworm Jim.
That's amazing. So,
also, when I was at Retrotaku, all I could keep thinking was, Je suis dans mon gym. Because there's a place near our favorite gaming store named
Diamond Gems,
and that is a reference
to
Tim and Eric's billion-dollar movie. Yeah.
So, John, what are your favorite pair of boobs in gaming?
My favorite pair of... Oh, my God!
Not your favorite parrot boobs. Your favorite pair of boobs.
Well, that removes all of those boobs on parrots.
That's true.
Richie says, I like Chun-Li's thighs more than any gaming boobs.
Fair enough. That's, he's got that's, some monster thighs.
Yeah.
But we'll get to thighs and ass in a minute. We're talking about boobs right now.
Well, I mean, obviously, Mai is doing pretty good on that list already.
I think my favorite boobs originally were probably Tifa's from Final Fantasy VII.
See, I didn't play. I've never played like any of the Final Fantasies.
Amanda says,
shit post on John.
You can touch your own dick from now on.
We're talking about.
Well versed at that.
We're talking about favorite boobs in video games, not favorite boobs in real life.
Yeah, that's. You actually exist, which is why it precludes you.
I'll take Tifa.
G says, but the vintage quality thighs, they've been to a saddening degree in recent years.
Yeah.
That's true.
That's true.
Retro NES 2600 says, favorite shrimp in gaming.
Mega Man 2.
Shrimp from Mega Man 2.
So, turns out alcohol is not a performance-enhancing drug. I have been doing terribly in this game.
Zelda's Final Fantasy says, I like small boobs only because I like the perky look. I'd have to say Princess Peach.
Thanks, also girl. I like big boobs. My ones are like perky boobs too.
Too many of the big ones just they lose.
Listen, pal, my boobs are gonna look like this when I'm 90. Okay.
Well, kind of.
It's a fair argument.
Charlie says I'm not a boob person. Going with Cammy's butt.
I'm a.
Stop, drop, and retro. Favorite boobs: Natalia's from GoldenEye.
How do I keep falling for
Link
the same
Luffy.
Mistake?
Oh, we already read that one. No, favorite shrimp in gaming is the tempura shrimp in Monster Party.
All right, so now let's talk about some ass. Favorite
says,
ass
oh, shit.
In gaming.
I gotta go with Tony.
Favorite ass in gaming. I like Cammy from Street Fighter. She's probably my favorite
Richie
ass in gaming.
Richie says, I like girls with one A and one B.
Me
no,
too,
don't,
dog.
Richie. Shut up. Retro NES 2600, as a butt guy, I'd still have to go with Mai. Tony's a butt guy.
What the fuck?
You are.
Butt guy? Like...
Yeah, he loves Ohio.
Like, from Ohio?
Butt guy.
Oh, I think you said butt guy.
Tony,
I heard butt guy. Did you not hear butt guy?
Tony talks to my butt and
Tony,
about my butt
Tony
multiple
is
times
sometimes
today.
Kind of an idiot.
Will no, I heard butt guy.
Listen... Me
Sorry,
guys, 8-bit stereo. Tony, I love your ass.
Oh, yeah, girl.
What ass? He has no ass.
It's also, just, I'm never showing my... I'm always facing camera.
It just goes back into legs.
That's not true.
It's true.
I've been working very hard with my ass.
Why not? It's the best of both worlds.
Richie.
Do you mean, like, you have one little one or one big one, or that butts are the tits of the back?
That's true, they are. They are the unsung nippleless heroes of the backside of a woman.
Keep forgetting.
Tony compared my butt to two hams.
They're like two
waiting to
honey,
be glazed.
Honey baked hams, just waiting to be. Like two globes. Like maybe.
Like
around.
Two hemispheres.
Yeah. I like that. And it's education.
You say two
John, what is Amanda's butt like? You should talk about it.
What is Amanda's butt like?
Poetry form.
I don't know that I want to talk about another person's butt.
Amanda, is it okay if he talks about your butt?
Wee guy says, I've seen it, man. I have my secrets, and I never tell. Richie, Chun-Li probably has a great ass, but she doesn't show it off. We do know Cammy's got it right.
Oh, yeah.
What about that Rainbow Mika, though?
She's what about male both. Characters? Okay, so what do you guys look for in male characters? Well,
now, hang on. There has been one ass in male gaming that you had to stare at for hours and hours and hours because that game would not accept any other way, and that was the ass of Solid Snake in Metal Gear Solid 4.
Mm.
Because he would keep doing that worm thing, and it would just be his ass.
Chase Maurice says, fave ass, that blurry one from the Knocked Out Guard in Metal Gear on PS1.
Nice.
Yeah, that's a good choice.
Bisexual tendencies.
Richie says Solid Snake has a pretty solid butt.
I like a good personality in a male character. Okay. I'm just kidding.
No. Tony, you have to do the...
Babe, you got crumbs all over
me. I know, I have crumbs all over me.
From Final Fantasy X.
Yes. Have you ever seen the Big Bang Theory videos where they remove the laugh track?
Yeah.
And then re-add in Titus as the laugh track?
Who was Shulk's friend in Xenoblade? Rylan?
It's been a while.
It's a guy.
Oh, Ryan.
Ryan. I would do Ryan.
Well, he's like, just like a bulky
even
man.
Though he was like, what a bunch of jokers.
You would do Ricky.
No! God, Ricky was freaking in
the little, it's
the
like an end
of Ricky.
No, he's like a little turn up.
Ricky
character.
Says, ooh, I'm Ricky. Ricky this. Ricky, oh, fuck you.
See? She says she'd fuck him.
No, I don't mean it. I like Jade's butt from Beyond Good and Evil. That was quite a bedonk. Ryan, yes, Ryan.
Was Trump stumped?
That's impossible.
Can't stump the Trump.
When is the next primary? Because I don't know. Oh, no, primary. No, I mean like next state.
Like a primary.
Oh,
like
I don't know.
I know Florida's the 15th.
Well, there's
so
another.
Wait a
there's
while.
Another.
Like a primary
whole other
color?
Round.
I gotta wash my hands. They're full of grease.
Well, yeah, that's like state primaries rather than presidential primaries.
I don't know. I just know if Trump is elected, I'm moving to Mars.
It's a good choice. You will die slowly as a... Oh boy. I think she was over here.
Void Extreme, I can turn her black shirt white. Are you talking... Who are you talking about?
It's getting freaky.
Getting freaky. Amanda says, is it bad that my favorite ass is from WoW?
Which ass? That's the important question.
Wee guy, it feels like no one is playing the game. It feels all pre-recorded. It's like the laugh track of a sitcom.
I assure you,
talking about me?
Playing it in the god-awful Steam controller.
You must have not seen our incredible freakout earlier when our game got shut down by something that was not me.
She claims.
I claim.
I think
true.
What probably happened was over time the cursor moved, and when you were pressing A, which is an enter, when it's
I picked
mode,
I picked dirt
it
track.
Probably clicked to close.
Yeah, but
the
that
game.
Doesn't mean that the game. I don't know. I don't understand what happened.
All we can say is thanks, Gabe.
I simultaneously opened another game and shut down the game we were playing, which I have no idea how that happened. Lesson learned: I should not be put in charge after 3 beers.
Yes, I showed up when the ass talk happened. That's my time to strike.
You guys make me feel like I have friends. That's how you guys make us feel.
Yes.
Spending your Friday night at home watching people play video games. Oh, yeah.
Bridget says, I think it's because they're not letting us hear the music. Is the game volume really
and
low?
And one particularly attractive friend. Are you talking about Tony?
Ooh.
He's
I can turn off the
audio. Super attractive.
Let us know if we need to
don't,
the
don't
game
play for a
yes,
second.
Yes, the guy
don't,
with the
don't
glasses.
Play for a second.
Come to Canada. Trump wins. I might.
I love all the conservatives who have been saying if Trump wins, they'll move to Canada. It's like, have you met Justin Trudeau?
Well, no, like, it's like now that Trump has a lead, like, all the conservatives that have been against him are going to be like, oh no, he's actually like really good. Oh, and we like
no, Tony, it's all right. You didn't press anything.
No, the guy with the white shirt. That's John. We all have glasses, don't we? Yes, tonight, we all have glasses.
Very central.
Sylvanas Windrunner.
Good choice.
Message retracted. All right, oh no! That's not good.
Alright, we're doing this, dog.
I'll have to take that back for a second.
What? You got a purty mouth.
Bet I'd like to poop in.
Yeah.
For me to poop in.
Finish up your beer, dog.
No, I am, and I'm going to start the fat tire now.
It's open, but you haven't started it? How did that happen?
It's not open. Like that's the one that you knocked down earlier. Will you get it from?
How did it spill if it wasn't open?
This is the one you spilled. Oh. That tire is not here.
Girl.
You need to stop drinking.
You need to stop tank.
Thank you. Grandhorn? What?
Oh my goodness. Richie, what are you doing tonight? Why aren't you here right now?
Richie, where's Allison? I like Allison better than you.
Whoa.
That's not nice.
Oh, that's a slam.
Listen, I don't mean it, but I just am pissed because he was being mean to me earlier.
Girl, Richie, where are you at? You guys should make it like a sitcom.
Amanda says John is kind of cute. Kind of.
Yeah.
John should burst into the room.
With the get rich quick scheme, and the rest of the live stream is him trying to order a rickshaw.
Will the Fonz make a cameo?
Sub-Zero or Ron Jeremy.
Ooh, tough choice.
I think it's which one would you rather bang a lot?
Who's Sub-Zero? The guy from that episode I was in?
Yeah.
Oh, definitely him. Ron Jeremy's gross.
He's just one of those inexplicable characters. Like,
well, he wasn't always didn't always look like that.
He's
like
the right
now, he's like way overweight. Like he used to be thin and trim.
Yeah, but
he was still in the era
of porn stashes. Nast.
Porn was a lot different back then. Also, he has a huge dick.
For them.
Does he? I mean, who cares?
You see, there's like monsters. Thanks, Monsanto. Enormous.
Yeah, but a lot of those are like prosthetic.
I have so many snappy crisps on my shirt right now.
Is that a euphemism?
No. You guys have seen me this whole time. It's just chips.
Ron Jeremy and Mario.
It's not that, big. Yeah, I trust you.
I've actually never seen a porno with Ron Jeremy, but like everyone says that he claims
in front of his
wife. I've only seen him on The Surreal Life, which was on like VH1 back in the early 2000s when VH1 was awesome and had like I Love New York and Flavor of Love and
Flavor of Love. I've actually legitimately never seen a porno with Ron Jeremy. Like, when I was introduced to Ron Jeremy, he was already a fat old man. You know what I mean?
He says that he's had sex with, like, 10,000 women. That's disgusting.
It's beautiful.
No, it's not.
Yeah, how else can you experience the insides of 10,000 people?
You guys are my favorite.
Unless you're a surgeon.
I'll bring drinks and snacks. Hell yeah, get your ass over here.
Do you live near
Detroit? That girl looks like Tina Fey. You mean me? I'm the only girl here, I'm gonna assume you mean me.
Richie, just come over, dog.
I thought of coming over because they work at 25 into Quinder now, so it wouldn't have been that far, but I need legit dinner, and then I work tomorrow morning, so I don't want to be out too late.
Boom,
whatever, man.
Richie,
fuck
boom,
you and your
Richie.
Real life job and your increasing income.
Yeah.
Oh, so, more Uber story time. I may or may not have pretended to be gay to get a better tip.
Yeah, didn't you say that you watched Queer as Folk?
Yeah, this guy, like, had mentioned, he's like, you know, every now and then, you know, I like to go to Ann Arbor, but only for Necto. And I was like, okay, I know what this means. I was like, oh, yeah, Necto, great place.
Bob Saget.
Saying stuff the whole time.
Because I have my glasses on.
Sorry. Go on.
And finally he's like, so you ever watch this one episode of Queer as Folk? And he's like describing this, and I'm like, I don't see that one. And I'm like, just trying to play along, and I was like, he'll give me a 5-star review.
This is like the third string Saturday Night Live cast, like people you never see, but are there just in case someone doesn't show up. Void Extreme, you are busting my balls, but I like it. I like how honest you are.
The club understudies.
Guess what? Tony's here. John is here. They're first string. You're referring to me. I get it. I just didn't want to be alone tonight.
She gets some.
I think you should clarify in every live stream that you are the only girl there. People can easily confuse John for a Rosie O'Donnell lesbian. Amanda says, dot, dot, dot. I can see it.
Yeah.
By pretended to be gay, John means gave a guy a blowjob.
So that's I luckily it didn't get to the point where the guy was like, By the way, here's my number. Otherwise I would have been like, I'm in it straight.
Shut the fuck up, Dickwad says, John looks like Life with Louie. Amanda says, John, you better have swallowed.
Life with Louie? Is that?
I think like Louie is gay.
Because there was Lucky Louie, and then there's just Louie.
And then there's Louie the dog. So, Richie, I think you should skip work tomorrow and just shoot with Dave and John and I. How about you?
Yeah, skip work. Fuck CBS.
Be
they
like,
don't need their,
fuck you,
they don't need their insulin.
Just go to CBS and be like, I'm a Walgreens man, son.
Yeah, and then drop the mic and leave, and just buy a microphone and drop it.
Fuck y'all, son. I'm going to Rite Aid. No one, Rite Aid is kind of failing. I think they're having some trouble, actually, as a matter of fact.
Yeah, I never go to Walgreens.
I said Rite Aid, girl.
Rite Aid, whatever.
Walgreens is doing well.
There's a CVS on every corner. Here's some booze, let's get low. You guys should look up a music video called The TWP. It is amazing.
Township.
50 next time.
Are you just gonna do this forever during the stream? Are you gonna continue?
No, I've been doing other things. I'm just trying to get her bonus for quote unquote impressing her.
That's very sensual.
Is that that bored bitch in the corner?
Yes. And then she never truly gets impressed. It's kind of a joke.
Life with Louie is a cartoon that a small fat kid that complains about life.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
But Louie Anderson was there supposed to be his kid.
Oh yeah, Louie Anderson.
I liked that show. I actually thought it was pretty good.
He's the guy who did like Price or not Price is Right. What's it called? Family Feud for a while.
Maybe. Yeah. I don't remember, but I want to watch that show. I used to watch that show quite a bit actually as a kid. I also used to watch Eek the Cat. I like that show. That was a good-ass show.
Why didn't anybody tell me this cheese was so good? Some good-ass cheese.
Cheese.
There it is. There it is. Now I can buy my health.
If you vote for Bernie, you wouldn't need to work at CBS. Everything would be on a Reddit day-by-day voting system. Everything would be free. She works at CVS as a pharmacist, not as a retail
worker.
So
he gets quite a bit more money.
Yeah, Richie is a doctor. He's a doctor of pharmacy. He's not concerned about a minimum wage job at the moment. He's doing very well for himself. Los Angeles, girl! I used to live in LA for 3 months.
All right,
John, you're like the brother I never.
You guys are awesome.
Can you not even? That's the question.
I love you guys. Like, this is so fun.
John, you don't even do it. You're just in this fucking village. Like, continue.
That milkmaid doesn't want to deal with your shit right now.
Oh my god.
I upgraded our health. I did all of
these
things.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay, but...
No. I will kill King Knight.
Is or is not this game way more entertaining than what we were playing before?
I don't know. I wanted to finally see some tank titties, but I
don't think it was going to happen. I really don't think it was going to happen.
I don't know.
Ted Belcher, a lot of boys. Hey, Whiskey.
I actually saw a person with a real last name Belcher today.
Huh.
Like Bob Belcher?
Yeah, it turns out Belcher is a real last name.
You guys know about the Sam Hyde?
Girl!
Sam Hyde?
What does that mean?
Did somebody just mention Sam Hyde?
No, he literally said Sam Hyde.
You guys know about Sam Hyde. Maybe he meant Sam.
Sam Hyde
is Dave Mysterio's Hyde.
Gift to humanity.
Ted.
Ted?
The guy who said, I'm Ted. Ted Belcher. Pay attention.
It's hard for me to read from this angle.
You stole my Zevia.
Girl.
Your Zima?
No, Zevia.
I'm going to steal something else later.
No, you're not. Maybe. Maybe if you put on your Link outfit.
But we're saving ourselves, baby.
We're saving ourselves for marriage.
Second marriage.
Double marriage. Second breakfast. Brunch, if you will. Brunch is the greatest. You know what I fucking hate? I hate brunch places where you order. Brunch is a buffet.
Yeah, it's
brunch
disgusting.
Brunch is a buffet. If you say you're brunch, but you just happen to serve food between breakfast and lunch, fuck you for false advertising. You should be thrown in jail for fucking treason, okay? I don't believe in the death penalty, but I do in that case, because that is false
advertising. I will agree with you 100% right there.
Brunch is, will always be, and should always fucking be a buffet.
I like my Tony's hammered and my John's stirred.
That's right. Double bubble thumbs up this video if you think brunch should be a fucking buffet. With homemade waffles,
brunch great again.
The place who serves brunch should have their own whipped cream that they make themselves.
Well, yeah.
Okay? Do-it-yourself waffles and or waffles made for you. Some seafood on the side. Some fucking
Tony
brisket
up in here. Tony starts talking about brunches
I
and spreads
love
when he's
talking about the spread.
Tell us
I
about the Jewish
spreads.
Spread.
Okay, I went to this bar mitzvah once, okay? Because
the spread's always the best at
yeah.
bar mitzvah.
So here's the thing is that, like, at this, I was a little, a different sort of situation. Like, at like a Christian church, you give in the little basket that comes around, like a little collection plate. Whereas, at least in the area I was working in, at the synagogues, you pay, like, a tuition, like a college, to be like a member. It's like a membership tuition, basically.
Yeah.
But as a benefit for doing this, my God, the spread. So
oh, yeah.
I went to this bar mitzvah afterwards. I wasn't expecting the spread. Okay, I wore my yarmulke. Like I was good. I walked out. Holy fucking shit, the spread. 5 tables long of desserts.
What kind of desserts?
Like little pies, little cakes, little truffles, little tarts, little like cookies, homemade lemonades. Oh my God. This spread was the best thing I've ever experienced in my life. It was the greatest day of my life. This bar mitzvah was the happiest day of my life, John.
It
was the happiest day
like
of my life,
was...
Anna.
Oh, I'm sure it was, because...
You have been living...
I believe you.
That spread was the best thing of all time.
I know.
It was better...
That's why on our wedding night,
married.
He
That's
shouted
right.
out, brunch.
Brunch! That's true, I did that.
He did claim the right of prima brunchta.
Yeah, I did. Oh my goodness.
You're making me hungry as shit right now.
Tony loves the spread. Damn, you're making me hungry. Whine about do da do da. Do 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 do. Oh my God. But listen, guys, who's ever been to a brunch that wasn't a buffet? And tell me how. Tell
okay,
me.
We went to Weber's for the brunch buffet, and it was good, but they didn't have.
It was
enough.
No Gandhi dancer.
Well, it was no Gandhi dancer, and they didn't have enough of a selection.
Look me in the eye.
You need to calm down right now.
No. Look me in the eye, people in the chat. And tell me,
look me in the
you
eye.
Aren't disappointed by a brunch that's not a buffet.
Okay, you
tell me you're not disappointed.
Right now.
Because if you tell me you're not disappointed by a brunch that isn't a buffet, you are a fucking liar.
Tony,
plain and
have
simple.
Some more sake.
No, plain and simple, you are a damn
Tony,
dirty liar.
Try this plum wine.
Thank you.
It's clear I'm driving
Ooh,
home tonight.
That's tasty, isn't it?
It's delicious.
Yeah. Try the plum wine.
I will try it. I'm refilling my husband's drink.
You're going to die, John.
I'm going to get him into bed.
It's going to be
our bed that we sleep in. Is this the plum wine?
Yes. Sorry.
Yes.
Is he still talking about brunch?
Seriously, Amanda, welcome to my life. I can't look you in the eye, Tony. You're not real. A place in D.C. called The Diner where you sit down and order and their brunch is hands down fucking amazing. It should be a buffet
with Swedish
meatballs.
Imagine if that place in D.C. But I was just in D.C.
Do you
want to where the hell were you?
The day of the Swedish meatballs.
No.
I'm passing it off.
So where were you? I was just in D.C. and I was like, dogs, what's a good place in D.C.? And I don't think you responded. What the hell? I'm going to be in Indianapolis in a couple weeks, actually.
With me? Maybe.
You, no, you don't want to use that.
I want to come. I want to come.
Stop pressing up an X.
I don't mean to.
Like A and B or your
We stop. Guy says stop. John.
I did not press X.
John, stop being a scrub
look,
at
no,
this
look,
game.
Look, look, look.
I clearly came for good gameplay. Mm-hmm. Ted says, and a buffet should always be a smorgasbord.
I agree with that, yeah.
I went to a very uncomfortable, rich bridal shower one time, and there were too many things to choose from. I wanted to eat everything that they had at the buffet, but I couldn't. I literally could not eat everything that they had. I had to choose, and it was really hard.
It was really hard, oh baby.
And they also told me that they would be uncomfortable going east of Woodward, which is where I live.
They're like, oh, yes, east of Woodward is so dangerous. Like, all of Rochester Hills? Like, what the fuck is...
Stop, Drop, and Retro says, don't be so down on a Jewish brunch that's not a buffet. What are you, shellfish?
Down on a Jewish brunch? What are you talking about? I was praising... First off, this wasn't a Jewish brunch. This was a Jewish spread, and it was amazing. So how could I be down on it if it was the best fucking spread I've had in my life? How is that even possible? It was the best spread.
Well, I need to get some klezmer music playing while you're ranting.
Spread. I forgot. It was so beautiful, John. John, you don't understand.
I just, yeah, like
I'll
I
never,
told you that he...
I'll never experience a spread like this again. Ever again, John.
You guys says, I feel like I'm taking crazy pills.
Continue.
This spread was so good, John. It was so amazing. Meats. The desserts. The spread. The lemonade.
Fiddler on the Roof, bitches. It's a really good movie. You should rent it.
Well, we don't want to put that too close, so they'll strike us.
Now I want prime rib.
Everyone in the chat is scared.
Scarred. Scarred. They're referring to what I said earlier.
Oh, yes.
Because this guy said, I would recommend a place to drink, but I'm not old enough. And I said, I hope we haven't scarred you.
How old are you?
Amanda, now I'm picturing a Jewish porn star.
Why? Ron Jeremy is Jewish.
This stream has progressively gotten better and better with more alcohol.
As it always does.
I want the breast spread, though, says Richie.
Oh, yeah. Richie, why aren't you here right now? Richie, I miss you. You need to hang out with me more. Why do you never call me, Richie? You're too busy working. Too busy twerking.
Link D. Luffy says, screw it, I'm making pancakes now. Wee Guy says, I'm not afraid of anything.
That's good. It's good. You shouldn't afraid.
I said, Richie, why aren't you here? Fuck you, man.
Richie, we need to have a stop spot day.
Oh my god, I want a stop spot so bad right now.
Next Friday. Stop.
Somebody spot bring spot. Us a pizza.
Yeah, somebody go to the stop spot and bring a pizza to Rochester.
Stop spot pizza. Nothing else.
Yeah. Fuck anything else.
They don't literally fuck the stop spot pizza.
It's hot.
It's hot.
It's really
very,
hot.
Very it is.
And every time they serve it to you at the bar, they're like,
shit,
don't fucking spill this on the floor.
Son of a bitch!
Because the platter isn't attached to the stand. And if you spill it, we're not fucking replacing it. And everyone who works there is sour and hates themselves, and that's why we love it.
Yeah. The people
we all
that are there
miss
are
Richie. Everyone does miss Richie. Richie needs to be up in this shit more.
I don't even understand what that says.
Dude, I've never called anyone. Don't even act like you don't know that.
Jesus. Man's gotta twerk for a living.
That's true. Richie's not a big caller. You gotta call the Richie to get him out. He doesn't call you. Yeah, you never have called me.
Richie.
You've never called me once.
Do you call Allison and talk to her? Because I bet she would love it.
How come you've never called me? Oh, Richie.
Bobby says, anytime I say stop spot, Evie starts chanting.
That's amazing.
Yes, you've trained her well.
Richie, why don't you call me?
Zelda's Final Fantasy says, I'll bring the pizza, but you guys have to dress up for me.
Oh, yeah, girl.
You mean dress down. Oh, yeah. All of our clothes off. What? Congrats. Congress Pizza for the win. If y'all are still shooting 6P tomorrow, I can cameo. You guys won't be still shooting then.
Yeah, I think we'll probably be done by then. I gotta be somewhere else at 6 p.m.
Guess what, Richie? Offer rejected.
Well, it's not rejected, it's just bad timing.
I could probably
special up. Formula 14. Well,
I gotta be open.
I'm sorry if I missed
no. You
said before.
I can bear turning him down, but I'm saying I would still be available.
What?
At our house?
6 tomorrow after we're shooting.
Oh, but yeah, I thought he was just meaning to shoot.
He meant to shoot. He meant shoot.
For a cameo. Yeah. All right. For a cameo.
I think I'm gonna go to Josh and Megan's tomorrow.
So,
are you going to visit their kid? Adam?
No.
You know, I was really disappointed in the reaction that people had regarding buffets. I was thinking people would like buffets more, especially brunch buffets.
It's all right, Tony. Sometimes you find out your fans are just terrible people.
Yeah, it happens. Who doesn't like a brunch buffet? I mean, my God, it's the best type of food, and it's unlimited quantities.
Richie says we're going to need that pizza with extra sausage, winky face.
Oh, yeah, girl.
Richie, I wish you were gayer.
Big sausage pizza, our official partner.
Oh my goodness. Mercy me. We are very small on the screen, aren't we?
We are pretty small. Maybe we should make ourselves bigger.
Yeah, I guess it's all right.
Wee Guy says, I agree with you, Tony, on the buffets. We're buddies.
That's right, Wee Guy. You know what's up. So, does anyone live in Indianapolis? I'm going to Indianapolis in a couple weeks, and I am going to have a lot of downtime.
For work.
Dobis.
Oh, okay.
And I might be there, too.
Yeah. So, I got a couple of meetings with a bunch of nurses, but then other than that, I don't have anything to do. So I need to figure out what the hell I should do in Indianapolis for, like, 4 days. Ah, shit, son. Shit, son. Hit him with that shovel. Hit him with that shovel, son. Put your balls in the asshole, Tone.
Freak that bitch out, Tone.
Oh my God, I hate that. He says it all the time.
I'm so happy I showed that to you, Tony.
So you guys should come to the Portland Retro Gaming Expo in October.
I've actually never seen it.
Plan that shiz out sometime.
Portland, like Oregon?
Probably, yes.
John and I are definitely going to SGC, the Screwtech Gaming Convention, this year.
I mean,
like, we need to again. I mean, we went in 2011. It was an amazing time.
Yeah. Now, if we could get the time to do, like, a road trip, like a genuine road... Oh, jeez. Unlike the road trip we did to Texas, which was just...
It was a little rushed.
Grueling.
It was
24 hours of just straight driving the whole way.
I can't believe you guys drove.
Honestly, there were times when I was driving at, like, late night where... And there were, like, semis going by where I thought I was just going to veer off the road.
Nursing a semi?
Like, yeah, the nursing a semi. I thought I was going to kill us. Like, there was one point in time where I pulled into a rest stop. Actually, no, like, we passed a rest stop. And I'm like, I bet there'll be another one. And then there's a sign that it's like, oh, the next rest stop, 60 miles. And I'm like, fuck me.
And yeah, I drove like another hour.
I drove for another hour and I pulled up and you're like, you pulled in and you're like, whoa, what's going on? I'm like, I'm dying. Like, I need to sleep. I'm going to kill us.
Okay, Chase says you guys need a life-size cardboard cutout of Richie to put out when he's not there.
That's what we did with John, except for his ashes.
And then Wee Guy says SGC. Oh, you mean Roos Teeth Gaming Convention and Screw Attack?
Yeah, they're being purchased by or combined with.
And then Roos Special Teeth. Formula really? 14 yeah. says I want to be my L on some tees. Tony looks like Rick
Moranis. I can't
Moranis.
Imagine what that says.
Thanks. Thanks. That's awesome.
Helmet or whatever his name is.
Dark helmet, yeah.
The only way to travel Texas is cross the state in one day. Good night, homies. Bye, Bobby.
Goodbye forever.
Yeah, but see, the great thing about Texas is those amazing speed limits.
Yeah. Well, here's the thing.
What are the speed limits?
Like 85.
Really?
Like, not making that
yeah,
up.
Not bad.
Oh my God,
you
can
go 90
that.
Without getting a ticket. See, everybody I know who has never been to Texas says they just hate Texas. Like, oh, I just fucking hate Texas. I hate Texans. You go to Texas and you're like, holy shit, this state isn't bad.
No.
I like this.
I like Texas. But,
it's a giant state. I mean, you know.
So, we were getting all those amazing deals, like, just because we were in my mother's hybrid at the time, which this time we'd be in my hybrid.
Oh, Jesus, I've died again.
So we would still be getting those. We would be able to use the HOV lanes. Mm-hmm. So we'd be going through that town like shit through a goose.
Oh yeah.
Assuming we don't just like, you know, fly or something like that.
Well,
and then Uber while we're there.
If we do opt to drive, the good thing is that it's on a 4th of July weekend. So I could take Friday off. We could leave like Thursday night, drive as far as we could to get a hotel, drive through the rest of Friday, get there Saturday, have a cool Saturday, Sunday, and then I have Monday off anyway, so we have a whole nice day to drive back.
Ooh. Because, yeah, as you're driving, it just gets slower and slower and slower and slower and slower, and every single thing has slightly more bars on it until you hit the Texas border, and then there were like, you know how all those other asshole states were making you go 55? Welcome to 85, and everything's fantastic now. Yeah. Welcome to Texarkana, and it's like, thank you.
Yeah.
Special Formula 14, what's everyone drinking? I'm drinking a Fat Tire. They're drinking sake.
Sake, plum wine.
And plum wine, which they have had quite a bit of. So if you guys think that I'm tipsy, welcome to Tony and John. John, apparently you also look like Drew Carey.
Let's see how much of the plane costs.
I can see that, yeah. I can,
you know, like, if we do it like now, like that early, we could probably get a pretty good deal.
Yeah, I could. I can take a look on my app that,
Let's fly, if we fly, let's fly Delta, because I get Sky Miles, and I can check bags for free.
You mean they're the ones who fuck you the least?
Yeah, well, I have a Delta Amex, so I can use miles, so I get better pricing, and I can check bags. So even if you have extra stuff, we could stuff it in my bag and just do that. And then it'd be free.
Man.
Yeah, exactly. Anyways, let's stop talking about SGC and logistics. Back to the chat.
I'm handling it. Just relax.
I wish I had something to drink. Too bad I have zero tolerance for alcohol. Tolerance is built, son.
Yeah, it is. It's true. When I first started drinking, I could have like one beer and be hammered. And then I really committed to it. And by the time I graduated college, I was a full-blown alcoholic.
That's right.
Anna, high five.
High five.
High five, my hobbies.
Oh, man.
So, did you guys hear about how Sacha Baron Cohen snuck the Ali G outfit in?
To where?
No, but I heard he wasn't
supposed to the Academy Awards.
I know that he still lashes on Ryan Seacrest.
No, that was previous years.
I drink free coffee across the street from Twitch downtown, whatever, something's on.
Anna, you gotta read them to us.
I am!
Don't, John, just reply yourself.
Alright. Doesn't mean I haven't tried, it's just not in my blood, says Wee Guy. Good for you, man. You know, don't force anything.
Yeah, son.
If you can be amazing sober, then you're better than any of us.
Yeah.
We only like ourselves when we're drinking.
That's right. It's only making. It's the only way I can tolerate my wife.
It's true. I mean, I don't even know his middle name or his social security number.
It's Mr. Wumples.
That's Louis.
That's true.
Name.
That's Louis'
it's
name.
True. That it's true. That is Tony's legal middle name.
Little like middle name. So I want to talk to Richie.
I don't even know his eye color.
I
want to
talk to Richie. Richie, are you still there, dog? So we're shooting tomorrow too at about 12:30 with the Parazzo.
That should be Parazzo Bot.
Yeah, Parazzo Bot.
Damn, I have to vacuum.
Yeah, girl, you got vacuum.
I've been amazing sober for pretty much all my life, so I say I'm keeping it up pretty good. Well, good for you, because we are so boring sober. Like,
we're only happy if we're drunk.
I don't know.
No, the
worst. I would live my life.
The worst are the people who like. Think like, oh man, I'm so boring when I'm not high, when I'm not like smoking.
I don't think it's
and it's like, no, you're just boring. No.
I think they're boring.
I watched Super High Me, and the guy who is the main character in that, I want to punch in the fucking face, because like the whole movie he isn't funny at all, and then he goes like, man, I haven't smoked in ages now. I'm not funny anymore because of the weed. It's like, no. You were never funny. You only thought your own jerks were funny because you were high.
Yeah.
That's the worst. That's why there are only a few stoner comedies I like. Like, oddly, Cheech and Chong's Up in Smoke works amazing even if you don't smoke or never have smoked. That's a really funny movie.
Anna, you're just replying to them without reading
that. I'm talking about you. Okay. Special Formula 14 says Wee Guy equals no fun zone. Well, I don't agree with that. I think you guys are all equally fun no matter how much you've been drinking. Wee Guy says, also, I love Drunk Tony. He's so lovable. I said, haha, glad you think so.
The Triple King?
Oh.
Ted Belcher, when I play Nintendo, my eyes light up like I just hit a pipe, and I stay up all night until my body turns off. Wee Guy says, it's all good. I make up the fun zone in other areas. I say, it's funny because Drunk Tony is just Tony times two. He's the same person, but extra silly and adorable.
Oh.
Doug Benson. I saw Doug Benson live at the Fargo Theater in Hollywood. Waste of time.
Oh, was that the guy who hosted that movie? Yeah. I think it is. Yeah. I got to see Jim Jeffries live. That was the last person I got to see
whale
live.
Is
and that was a couple of years ago, and that was amazing. He is the king of the truples, which are half trout, half apple.
Oh my god. I like his little dance.
Tony is, okay, I don't know if you're still there, Zelda's Final Fantasy, but...
Are you still there?
Half of this has been talking to just
I'm willing to admit now that most of our cosplay is just me dressing up as a fish, because Tony's really attracted to marine life, but you know what? I should be more specific. It's not a fish. It has to be a aquatic mammal.
Yeah, those aren't fish, baby.
Whale,
are you talking about
dolphin,
aquatic ape theory?
Aquatic ape theory.
I don't know. I just know he sticks it in extra hard.
Oh my god! You are drunk.
That's one for the blowhole.
Into my blowhole, perverts. That is not what I was talking about. Tony and I have never even had sex.
That's true. We're saving ourselves for double marriage.
Double marriage? What is this? A sandals resort?
Oh my god. Well, good job, Anna.
Sorry, guys. I have had four beers.
Oh, watch out, son.
Watch this. Yeah,
shit. Son, eat it. I like his horns. He's like, I think I'm in Skyrim, but I also think I'm in Mega Man. I don't know. Whatever.
The soundtrack for this is truly amazing.
It is quite good, isn't it? It's also scary. It might be a little too scary.
Chase Marie says, gotta go. Much love for, from Regina, Canada. Keep it up.
Canada.
Which province?
My home native land.
I will forever say that Canada has a rich history because that is where Leslie Nielsen was born.
Oh, that's true.
There are other reasons.
Is Leslie Nielsen even still alive?
No,
he died like 5 years ago.
Well, he was very funny, and rest in peace.
He was an amazingly funny man, and he was the star of one of my favorite sci-fi films.
Naked Gun 2.5. There you go.
Yes. 33 1/3, Anna.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm sorry. That is a deer in a dress.
Oh, yeah. If you talk to the deer lady, she often just says you're too short for me. Oh, that one says that, but if you wait for the one that's, I think, in a blue dress.
That's a horse.
That's a horse.
Gotcha. There's a horse lady.
Relax.
Oh, hang on. Here's the lady knight.
I dig it.
Okay, that's... You have to wait for the other deer lady.
So you guys, we need you to, like, give us topics to talk about, because at this point our brains are
mush,
barely functioning.
So ask us some questions.
So
like the end of an Uber
need
shift.
We need topics.
Topic. Topical
even if it's
topics.
Like geography.
Some topical
you know,
cream
trivia.
Topics.
Some you
topical
know, celebrity
topical
news. Anything like
about.
That.
Let's
we
talk
just,
about
we
Kim Kardashian.
Ideas.
Let's talk about Kim Kardashian.
That's all anyone ever talks about ever.
We guy
this
says I love Naked Gun in all 33 1/3 of those.
I thought
movies.
The second one was kind of bad, but the first one and the third one was good.
I There are weak parts of the second and third, but I still love them.
I haven't seen any of them.
Anna?
No, the second one was... It did have some great lines for me, like the... What was it? What was his wife's name?
Guinea Pigtress?
Tony starts talking about guinea pigs a lot when he's drunk.
Whatever her name was, he just... Oh, Elaine, and he's like, Elaine. That name will always remind me of her. And I think that was the one that had the, like a midget at a urinal, I'm just going to have to stay on my toes.
Special Formula 14 says favorite color? I like green. Tony doesn't see colors.
I don't see colors because I'm not racist.
He's colorblind. Office fans.
I get it, because he's not wearing a collar.
Yeah.
I can only remember the intros of those movies. I also love the Austin Powers movies. I'll take D-list celebrities for $100.
D-list celebrities?
Like Courtney Scodden. You know, she's the one that married the guy from Green Mile when she was 16 and he was like 50.
You know who my favorite celebrity is, though?
Green Mile? His name was Doug something?
Doug Funny.
No.
That's not funny, John. But
it's pretty funny.
There's an A-list celebrity that makes all other celebrities look like A-list celebrities. And that is David Perfect Tempurazzo.
Oh, okay. I thought you were going to say...
Beautiful, beautiful man beast. Absolutely wonderful. David Perfect Tempurazzo. Wonderful gentleman.
Wonderful gentleman.
Wonderful gentleman.
Possibly
gentleman
a
and a scholar.
I tried watching Fuller House. It was fucking awful. Yeah, the trailers looked pretty fucking awful.
You know, I had started to think, you know, there's so many people, there's so much effort into, like, truly, truly amazing, like, streaming content. I was like, how long until they make just some terrible sitcom? For the general audience, and now it's Fuller House the next day. I was like, damn it, because I mean, like, Transparent's won a shitload of awards. Yeah. Orange is the New Black. There's
New
been
Black
amazing, amazing streaming stuff. The Man in the High Castle, if you haven't watched it, that's good shit. It's good shit. I mean, yeah, it's about what if Hitler took over America, but it's tasty.
Yeah, Fuller House got renewed for a second season, too.
Okay, so who in the chat likes Big Bang Theory? This isn't a trick question, it's a trick question. It's a very big trick question.
Stan, what do you
do? No, you can't do anything. It's just lagging behind.
Wait, you can't? Oh, just refresh.
Awesome.
Alcohol has not helped my reflexes.
So how long did you want to go tonight? We've been going for about 2.5 hours or so.
I did. 3, I think, is a healthy girth.
Okay.
He did it to refresh.
It should still be working.
Let's see what's going on here.
Aha! 2,500. Now I can buy that thing that I needed. So what do you guys think of Shovel Knight?
It's a delight.
It's
a delight
like
to the senses. We go to my channel. Oh, we're in, son. What do you guys think about... Let's see here. Talk about the G4 network. Stream offline. Fuller House. What happened?
Yeah, I don't know what's
farted.
Going on.
Titties.
It's
it died.
Comcast. Comcast is the answer to that.
Boobies. Oh, hello. I think we're on again. What do you guys think about game trailers ending? Were you fans
that's
of their stuff?
It's kind of sad that they're gone.
I was a big fan of game trailers back in like 2009, 2010, 2011, even up to 2012. But then what happened was that like kind of Screw Attack ended their partnership with them, or game trailers ended their partnership with Screw Attack one way or the other. There wasn't any angry video game nerd stuff on anymore, no parental floss or whatever. And then, like, their shows were still really good. They did some awesome retrospectives, but then they kind of started whittling down their content. And yeah. I liked the Pack Attack, which was kind of like a financial analyst's view of the video game industry. And they axed that. And they just axed all the shows I liked. And then they came back with a couple of decent shows, but they just kind of... They were like, it wasn't enough, and they would rarely do video reviews anymore. I don't know.
Yeah.
Like, so it's sad, but like you could see that the higher ups were slowly trying to strangle the life out of it as time went by.
Oh man.
They're arguing over whether Big Bang is a good show or not.
Oh, jeez.
I can solve that. It isn't.
I watched one episode that was, like, okay for a sitcom.
There's a few episodes here and there.
It wasn't great. Like, it was all right, though. But, like, it wasn't, like people are... Like, I guess the problem I have with Big Bang Theory isn't that it's not a good sitcom. It's that... People who don't understand gaming culture are like...
Or nerd culture.
Are like, whoa, you're gonna love this because you play video games.
Yeah.
And it's like, that's... It's like, no, it's really more...
A lot of sitcoms nowadays just... Well, I guess always have just aimed straight for the middle. So it's like, some of it you're gonna find funny and some of it you're gonna think is dumb.
Yeah.
Unless you're just like... I'm sorry, but like... Unless you're at the bottom and you just think it's, like, hilarious.
Yeah. But, like, I don't know. Like, it definitely aims for the middle. It's very, like, baby boomerish sentimentality in terms of humor. But, yeah, I mean, it's really more so, like, the annoyance of being like, oh, you're going to love this because you like video games.
My dad...
It's more, that's more annoying than anything, I think.
My dad had a coworker tell him, like, you know, Mike, you're a real smart guy. You remind me of the Big Bang Theory. And my dad was like, huh, never heard of that before. So he watched an episode and had the guy apologize the next day.
Oh, my God.
It's just like, my God, that show was awful. Because it's like... In a lot of ways, it's like the writing. It's every once in a while they'll have like a funny thing. It's like Saturday Night Live,
yeah,
or Mad TV. From time to time, they'll have like a really funny concept, and then.
Well, to be fair, it was a sitcom, and I used to be really into Friends, and I thought that it was like hysterical. And now that I watch it, it's like so dated, and it's so
careful. We'll lose all of our fans from the UK for
no. I love Friends, but like I only love it because I grew up with it, and I, you know, adore the characters and everything. But if I were to watch it now, I wouldn't necessarily get it just because it's so dated. Like it's so. I mean, their last episode was in like 2005.
Yeah, but Big Bang Theory is contemporary.
It's contemporary, and that's why I'm saying, like, it doesn't really have an excuse, because Friends was in the era of, like, laugh tracks and that kind of thing.
Well,
and,
I think TV
only
has...
Only three walls and that kind of thing.
I think TV has changed quite a bit, but, like, Big Bang Theory, just, like, all sitcoms, they aim for the middle. So they try to get as many people as possible, because the humor aims right for the middle.
To quote Mark Simpson, aim low, aim so low that even failure will look like a success.
Yeah. Exactly.
Fuck off, Ghost.
Are there any games you wanted to review but just haven't done it?
Risk of Rain.
Risk of Rain, we're reviewing that tomorrow, though.
Yeah, well, yeah. I thought we'd give that as a nod, and then they'd be like, oh, we suggested that.
I fucked that up, sorry.
Tony revealed that there is no Wizard of Oz.
Yes. I don't know. I mean, I think that, I don't know if there's any games I really, really want to review that we haven't reviewed yet. I mean, they kind of come to us at random, and then we review them, basically.
Yeah, in a lot of cases, yeah.
Good points on game trailers, thanks. That's a pretty good summary of when and how they went wrong for a lot of people. Da-da-da. 4chan is a better representation of gamer culture than Big Bang.
Yeah, but V has kind of turned to crap with, like, just how much, like, half the time I go on there, if I find a single thread I want to join, it's, like, deleted in, like, 5 seconds because the mods are insane.
This is amazing. Amanda says, Big Bang Theory is fucking nerd blackface.
Yeah, I'll agree with that. Yeah, it is.
It's nerd blackface.
It's just more gentrification of nerd culture. I've heard that used several times.
Yeah, about, I can, like, totally see that.
How people are like, oh my gosh, you know how many times I've seen The Avengers? You won't believe this. Twice. So yeah. I'm gonna go to this convention.
They all agree with her.
Yeah.
And it's gonna blow your mind.
Yeah.
And it's like, Mitchell was joking that I should go to a furry convention, and I was like, shit, yeah, I'll go to one. And he's like, wait, really? And I was like, yeah. Have you seen how many disgusting normies there are at, like, every other convention now? It's just, like, peak normie. I was like, I'd rather go to a furry convention at this point, or a gaming convention, because everything else is just going to be like, let's talk about triggering or some shit like that.
Yeah, or I don't think I'm ever going to go, like, to a furry convention. Although, TJ went to one instead of going to Bobby's wedding.
Talk about talking shit. That's true.
Well, it's true.
It is actually true.
Must have been a really good convention, though.
It was the big one.
It was the big one, yeah.
I'm not of that persuasion, and even I know that's the big one.
I really think if you did a rare SNES Tecmo Bowl review, Tecmo Super Bowl 2, very rare cart, you'd get good hits because NFL football equals new viewers. I don't know about that. I don't know if I agree, because when you search NFL games on YouTube, there's no way you're going to appear in the first page. Like, there's no way whatsoever. Like, we have a program that actually analyzes your tags in video and showcases how they appear as if they were searched. And the more popular the game, the more difficult it is to appear. The more rare the game, the easier it is to appear because you're the only ones doing it. However, if you have something like an NFL game and your tags are like NFL, Tecmo, whatever, I think, like, you like anything with NFL, you're going to be like page 1,000,000. I don't know if anyone would find us. That would be the problem I would have. Amanda says, can we just agree that To Catch a Predator is the best comedy ever?
That's terribly sexy. Laugh out loud. This time, things will be different. Agents from Perverted Justice will be with us. Oh my god.
To Catch a Predator is a great comedy, but no one ever won the child. It's such a cliffhanger ending.
The girl who was the bait.
Yep.
She's now a model.
Really?
I'm not kidding.
That's awesome.
Yeah, so how about that?
How about that?
Look it up.
Look it up, son.
I spend way too much time on /TV to know that.
Clearly.
This is too intricate for a drunk person.
I know. Isn't it awful? Like, it's...
I almost just destroyed everything again.
It's alright.
Girl?
Did you drink all the beer? It's all gone!
Darling, you drank all the beer.
Anna, do you want some plum wine?
Yeah, I guess I do.
Are you plum-tuckered?
Plum-tuckered.
Three sips of your sake before you can have your plum wine.
That's true.
Should have brought more beer, man.
You know, we should have Bill Nye.
The science guy? Yeah, I like that idea. So, what are some additional questions that you might have for the Hartford Games crew here? We're probably going to be streaming for another 15 minutes or so. So, get them all out while you have them. Get them all out.
You got to vent it. You can't bottle those questions.
Can't bottle those questions up.
Yep, you can't.
You can't do it.
So technically, you could.
You could.
Well, but that's just how you. That's how you. You know, hurt yourself.
That's how you hurt yourself.
Hurt other people.
Hurt other people. BYOB, mate. Bring your own beer, son. We did actually bring our own beer. John did not offer us any beer.
Bring your own bottle.
I did bring whiskey, though.
It means bring your own bottle.
It could mean both.
Trump or Clinton? I don't like either Trump or Clinton, actually.
Whoa!
Okay, if I was given the choice between Trump or Clinton, I would pick Clinton.
Yeah, I'd pick Clinton, but I don't like either of them.
Now, I forewarn you that only one of them is stompable.
That's true.
I voted for Clinton.
Yeah, so we go to the election, like the primaries, and I'm like, I'm voting for Bernie. Like, should we even go? If you're voting for Clinton, we're just canceling each other out. And she's like, I'm voting for Clinton. And I'm like, all right, well, that's one and one. That just means nothing. Let's just not go. And she's like, no, let's go. I'm like, but it's pointless.
What I meant was, like, no, Tony, listen, what I meant was, someone will always cancel someone out. If you think in that way, you might as well just never vote ever.
I know, but when you have specifically a pair of individuals...
I understand that.
Now,
but what
now,
I'm
Tony.
Saying is, our votes still did count.
Tony, the yes. correct thing...
But not in the percentage, but in the total count, yes.
That's okay.
Tony, the correct response is to vote for Trump.
Yes, I should have voted for Trump. No. You're right.
I did consider getting a Republican ballot just to vote against him.
That's
now,
not
who would you vote for against him?
I don't know. That's why I didn't do it.
Probably Rubio, because he has the least possibility.
Definitely not Cruz.
Not Cruz.
Yeah. Cruz terrible.
Cruz is the Zodiac killer.
Kasich?
Kasich, I don't mind Kasich.
Yeah, he's probably the one that I would vote
Although,
for.
Although, to be honest... The biggest farce in this election is they didn't allow the one person who should have been on there. Arnold Schwarzenegger should have been on that ballot. He'd have taken the whole thing.
Satan were being
I would have voted for him.
John,
I'd have been a liberal my whole
Bill
life.
McAlpine.
Bill McAlpine?
What?
That is your father, darling.
Why is my
what
dad on here?
Satan were a being
Oh my god, Dad, what are you doing right now?
He isn't.
I've always thought that Satan was a baby boomer.
It fits the bill.
It fits the bill. Do you get the bill?
I can't.
Are you implying my father-in-law?
I can't continue to function right now knowing my dad is on here right now. What do I do?
Anna's breaking
more
down.
Anna,
drink more, Anna.
Drink
Anna,
more.
Quick, drink.
Okay,
quick, drink. Hell yeah, Bernie. Zelda's Final Fantasy says, would you ever name your kid after a video game character, Anna?
Oh my god, Dad.
I can do this?
I'm responding to this right now.
Your father can hear your voice.
I know, but we're lagging.
Oh my goodness.
I can't believe your dad is on this.
That's awesome.
That's awesome. Yeah, Bill McAlpine.
How did you get on here? You're amazing. I love you. Well, I tagged you in the post about it, baby.
I know.
Well, then why do you need to ask him how
well,
about it?
Well, I didn't know. Listen, I've been drinking. I don't know what's going on.
Just not
very abstract kind of.
It's a very, yeah, it's an abstract feel. Anna, answer the question. Would you ever name your child after a video game character? John, would you ever name your child after a video game character?
Robin Williams named his daughter after Zelda.
I do like the name Zelda, actually, as a matter
Zelda
of fact.
Zelda Williams.
It's a very, classic name.
He was playing The Legend of Zelda. Yeah. He was a huge gamer.
Yeah.
Oh no, Spectre Knight.
Link D. Luffy 15. What made you guys want to make Hardcore Games?
Do you mean the name or the show?
Probably the show.
The show? Okay, I'm going to answer the Zelda question first. I would name my child after...
Amanda says Amanda, or says Anna Smack John, so I have to smack you.
That's not a very good smack, darling. Gotta give him
a business.
Well,
I didn't mean it, because I don't know why she wants me.
Why is she
what?
I'm
trying to
say, me to smack?
I don't know.
You know, honestly, I
is
would
it
name...
because I would vote for Arnold Schwarzenegger? He's
I don't know.
A pretty good
I don't
guy.
Know how far behind we are.
I would name my firstborn child Shovel Knight Visentator.
Shovel Knight.
Why not?
Shovel Knight Visentator.
Shovel Knight
like
Visentator.
Dweezil or Moon.
Doesn't it have like a nice ring to it? I mean, it's good, right? It's a good name. So, let's see here. So,
any Game Gear memories? There isn't much on YouTube about that system.
Wait, we're gonna back that thing up just for a second. Though. I'm gonna
this
get
is
to that.
Report.
Oh, it is.
Yeah.
Game Gear memories. I didn't have any. I didn't have a Game Gear growing up. I bought one. I bought two from a Salvation Army because one of them had like a bad audio capacitor, which apparently is an issue. Mm. So I don't really. My only memories from Game Gear are being an adult.
Okay.
But there are some good Game Gear games.
That's a little handheld thing, right?
Mm-hmm. It looks like a handheld. It's basically a master system with a lower resolution but a higher color palette. So what made us want to do Hardcore Games, John?
That would be playing NBA Jam in your basement and sort of slowly. I remember TJ originally going like, oh god, Tony just won't stop playing NBA Jam. And I was like, really? I haven't played that game in ages. I should play that with him. And then we were playing that for a while, and you were like, I think we should make a show out of this.
Yeah.
Us, like, commentating and playing games.
I think also, too, like, at the time, it was post-college, pre any sort of significant
work. Well, post-your college.
Post my college, pre any significant work for me. So it was like, I was trying to find work, but it was also like, what do I do meaningful? Like, it's meaningful, like, in a creative way.
Skills.
Yeah. Sure. So, like, you know, it was the NBA Jam, but it's like, let's do something where it's like, you know, we can make content. You know, it's fun. Like, for Richie, he could continue making music, you know?
Yeah.
And sort of flex that creativity. So, for us, it was kind of like a creative outlet with our favorite hobby to be able to just, like, have fun, have a beer with friends and such.
Oh my god, my dad said Lindsay Lohan, but I have no idea why.
Because that would be... she's not a video game character. Dick Van Dyke.
Oh, wait. Hypothetical, you have to pick your next leader. It can only be either Trump, Lindsay Lohan, or Hitler's ghost. Oh my god, I agree with you, Dad, for sure. I can't believe my dad is on here. He's so freaking sweet. I love him.
So, we just touched our feet together. Like that.
Next, it'll be dicks.
I would say Hitler's ghost. Because it's relatively...
Why?
Because Hitler's...
He would kill people.
No,
he's Hitler, retro.
Hitler's retro.
He's retro.
He's probably gay. And he's probably...
Yeah, but gay people can be evil, too.
I don't know.
Because he's a ghost.
No.
You'll be able
yes,
to...
Yes, they can.
No, they Anna, cannot.
Anna.
Hitler was probably gay, and he's evil.
But at this day and age, he'd be able to come out. He'd be able to be free. Go to Ferndale. Michigan.
He would live in the same town as me, and I would be really upset.
And he would be... He'd be an okay guy. Plus, ghosts are pretty benign most of the time. And what is a ghost going to do? Can't hurt you. Right? So
I ain't afraid of no ghosts.
I ain't afraid of no ghosts. So I would say Hitler's ghost. That's a good... I like that question.
And because we'd be able to
see
that
ghost. Such a heartwarming stream.
Such a heart... They're referencing you.
Love you. I'm out.
Anna, you're silly.
Well, I love him, and I'm so happy he joined.
He could only tolerate us for, like, 5 minutes.
Well, that's...
Probably only could tolerate you for 5 minutes.
Whoa.
That's enough.
Shots fired.
Amanda says, Anna, I'm only on here because you amuse me. I'll have to join more streams then.
Yeah, John and I are pretty boring. Dude, only gay, if only gay Hitler's ghost was fuck here. John, you look tired. You ever been tested for diseases?
What was that from?
It was from the...
Oh, yeah.
And the response is... So let's do that again.
Hey,
John, you look tired. Have you ever been tested for diseases?
At least I'm not a hideous... fucker.
That's good. Well,
everybody's leaving. We should probably stop.
We'll play for another 5 minutes. Ease into that.
I gotta use this meal ticket.
I'm gonna go to Ram's Horn.
You wanna go to Ram's Horn?
Yeah.
We can go to Ram's Horn.
Ram's Horn?
Get the horn.
There's literally a ram right there.
Oh my god, 6,000?
I need to watch this again, because I look like a retarded baby.
You do look like a baby.
Retard. Oh my gosh.
he goes, stop dropping retro, says he can't sign anything into law, he's a ghost, it's a sure thing.
Well, you see, the thing is, I personally don't think a Trump presidency would be that bad, because he would throw so many tantrums, he would never get Congress or the Senate to ever do what he wanted, because he'd be like, well, I want you guys to do this. And they're like, oh, good, we wanted to do that. And he's like, and you're a bunch of fucking pussies if you didn't, and they're like, you insulted us now.
Yeah.
So I think he would end up, despite his best efforts, being just essentially a stand batter.
Yeah.
He'd sandbag himself.
Yeah, I could definitely see that.
Namco has a special place in heaven.
Because, I mean, checks and balances, I mean, you could literally elect Adolf Hitler to the U.S., presidency, and you'd have checks and balances in place.
Yeah.
It wouldn't be as bad as you'd think.
Yeah, I'd still be able to have my bar mitzvah spread. It's important. I love a good spread, and you know
that. A good
that.
Spread is fantastic.
I love a good spread more than
listen, anything. A good friend of mine, when I was growing up, he had a bitchin' bar mitzvah, and I'll tell you, that fucking spread, man.
Bar mitzvahs cost pretty much as weddings.
And he... I felt... I was so jealous, because he had relatives donate so much money, because he was turning 13, and I was like, my 13th birthday sucked in comparison.
Oh, yeah.
Like, and he's like, you should be Jewish, and I was like, maybe I should.
Ted Belcher says, meet up at B-Dub's Dave and Buster's. Will Wee Guy says, RIP Tony's spread. Seriously, we're not going to find a spread that...
Oh, you don't
that
understand.
Clutch
that's
at this time of
nice
day.
Nice kosher little pies and such. Oh my god. Like.
Okay, Ted Belcher says, oops, B-Dub's Buffalo Wild Wings. I would so be in for some B-Dub's.
B-Dub's
right now.
Where?
Yeah, where?
Where? Where at that B-Dub, son?
I mean, there's one in town.
Yeah, but like he probably lives in like Washington State.
Yeah.
He probably lives in the Washington Monument.
I would have, somebody has to.
Someone has to
because
live in Washington Monument.
Because it looks like a penis.
Oh,
that's not
a
why.
Very good
super one. Pointy yeah. Like one.
Baby, I don't think you've ever seen the Washington Monument.
I've never seen a penis. I have seen the Washington Monument, motherfucker, more than you have, and it's pointy.
Are you kidding? I've seen the Washington Monument so many times. Don't you fucking even trip.
I saw it when I was 13, and that's enough.
I saw it. Hey. So many times.
I saw similar looking things when I was...
I just saw the Washington Monument, like, last week, babe.
Yeah, well, congratulations.
Were you there
it looked
with
exactly
her?
The same as when I
no,
saw it.
No, she... I was
in 2001.
Oh. It was Dobis. It was business.
Downtown San Francisco, near Twitch. Haha, can't make it tonight.
We're a little bit held up in Michigan right now. Oh, love you guys so much. Love you too.
Love you too.
Hey, watch
I'm so
hair.
Happy my dad. My dad is the best, you guys. Like, he's so fun to hang out with. He's, like, so cool.
He's, like, totes cool.
Is he double totes cool?
He is totes, like.
Totes, magotes?
Magotes, yeah. Wee Guy says, you make me have the laugh so good.
So good, baby, so good.
Point at your hand.
Oh, point at your hand where we are, I think, is what he's suggesting.
Oh, we're, okay, so...
Yeah, there you go.
Ish?
Detroit area. Metro
Detroit!
Yeah, that's right.
Detroit! Tony and I are much closer to Detroit than John is.
Yeah, John's a poser.
We're, like, actually near Detroit, John's not.
I work
when
on
I'm it. Working, that's not the case.
Not the
well,
case.
You work, your work floats. Yeah. You drive, right?
Detroit
I'm literally
is
in downtown
the
shit. Detroit
you guys should
days.
Come visit. Like, don't let its reputation fool you.
It's actually
shit.
Really
it
nice now.
Shit.
Yeah.
I go downtown there. There's people walking all over around. I'm like, why are there so many people? And then I'm like, oh, yeah, it's the city. Come to Detroit. It's the shit.
I work on 8 Mile.
Ooh. Okay, so his, you know, work is not in the greatest area, but...
You know, everybody shits on 8 Mile.
I'm
I don't
so
think
happy
it's that bad of an area.
And 2016.
I had a guy today when I was doing
you had a man?
I had a man in the biblical sense.
Yes. No, I like that. Did you get to know the man? Did you know the man in the biblical sense?
No,
I like
he
that.
Was like, so
Baby.
Tell me, he's like, be honest,
Baby.
Do
I
you conceal carry? And I was like, well,
sense.
I have a license too, but I don't. And he's like, well, do you like screen? Like, based on where people are, if you're going to go to that neighborhood when you're on Uber, I'm like, no, I just click everyone. And he's like, well, what's the worst experience you've ever had? And I was like, well, that was today. And this woman said, oh, is that a dog hair? And I was like, oh, sorry about that. Sometimes people, like, dog hair comes off of people from their jackets and stuff. I have this vacuumed every day, and she was like, and then she started eating chips in the back of my car. And I was like, oh, yeah, complain about the dog chips, and then eat, like,
the
dog hair, and then eat potato chips in the back of my car. Awesome. And that was the worst experience
I've had. What area was that in?
Tell me West Bloomfield. Tell me shitty fucking West Bloomfield.
No, it was weird because it was someone at an extended stay hotel, Birmingham. And they were dressed up.
They're going to
in like the most expensive clothes field. We went somewhere near there, and we went to a rental agency, and she walked in and was clearly talking to someone about renting a Maserati. And I was like, okay, yeah.
All right, that's the end of that. Well, on that note, it's about 11 o'clock. We've been streaming for about 3 hours.
Yeah, we should probably shut the stream off and then just continue drinking for another night.
Any final...
But for real, Tony. Do you want to go to that horn?
Oh, my God. I am...
If you really want to go to that horn, I can find out how much, like, an Uber...
I can, but I can't fucking drive right now.
No, that's what I was saying. I can see what an Uber is.
Thank you, everyone, for joining us. It's been good. It's been fun. It's been grand.
Also, John, your story is dank.
Your story is some dank ass.
Is it a dank
bum meme? Bum? I've never been farther than Ann Arbor.
Who is this?
Amanda.
You've never been further south than Ann Arbor?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I think she's been to Ann Arbor once when she
was. Ann Arbor is further south than Detroit. You just have to come a little bit this way.
Mm-hmm. Rochester Road.
Well, let's figure that out in a second. We're still live.
Yeah.
Let's do that. Hey, we have. I'm not gonna eat anything around Ramshorn, but John, we're still live. You wanna stop the stream, or do you wanna?
It'd be about $7 for me to get us out there, so yeah, I can do
all
that.
All right, guys, we'll see you later.
We'll see you all another time.
Thank you so much for watching.
We appreciate you guys.
I love just sitting here and getting drunk while nothing. Like I talked to you online.
You're saying that they're nothing.
I'm saying Tony isn't saying. Let's do another take of that. I think we need to try to do that again.
Yeah, you guys haven't... Luckily,
oh my God.
The greatest thing Hard for Games has done has cured Tony of a person we used to call Production Tony. Now, Production Tony...
He's going to get pissed.
His greatest feat was he always kept morons like us on track.
It's like herding cats.
He... was no fun at all, but you've learned
somebody needs to be no fun in order to get the job done.
But now Tony can be fun and get the job done.
Yes.
John, I wasn't the asshole you wanted. I was the asshole you needed.
Exactly. I was the hero.
It's all right. It's just a Mac. All right, three-way strength and honor.
Okay. Let's switch.
Yeah,
okay, here we go. There we go. That's good. Okay, I'm not gonna drop it. I'm not gonna drop it again.
Although, as much beef as I may give Mac, I think the Maglock charger is brilliant.
Oh my goodness, what does it say? See you guys next time. Okay.
You guys have left. Pizza!
Pizza, guys! Pizza for everybody! Pizza!
Control quit.
Okay.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more H4G game reviews, don't forget to subscribe to see new episodes every week. And for those interested, we have just started a brand new Patreon page. Definitely check it out. We're working on some great perks and rewards for you guys. Links are in the description below.